July 17, Dr. Marty withdrew cash for personal use, 150,000 pesos. Let's write the date. Please remember again that we are recording transactions from the viewpoint of the business, not of the owner. When Dr. Marty, the owner, withdrew or took out cash from the clinic, what happened to the cash of Marty Medical Clinic? It decreased. Being an asset, how do we decrease cash? By crediting it. The cash withdrawn amounted to 150,000. So on the second money column, let's write 150,000. This is a withdrawal transaction. The withdrawal or drawing account increased. What is the normal balance of withdrawal or drawing? Debit. So debit, Marty drawing. Also for 150,000 pesos. Then explanation. To record cash withdrawal. July 19. Rendered surgical service. Just from these words, even without completely reading the entire transaction yet, you should already know that there is revenue here. What is specific revenue account? Surgical fee revenue. So credit surgical fee revenue. Because having rendered surgical service, the surgical fee revenue of the clinic increased. And the normal balance or increased side of revenue is credit. How much must be the credit surgical fee revenue? Rendered surgical service worth 240,000 pesos. So 240,000 must be the credit surgical fee revenue. In exchange for the service, what did the business receive? Rendered surgical service worth 240,000 pesos to a patient who paid 150,000 pesos. And promise to pay the balance in 15 days. The patient paid 150,000 pesos. Therefore, the cash of the clinic increased. To increase the cash, debit cash for 150,000. And promise to pay the balance in 15 days. That means the balance mentioned here amounts to the difference between 140,000 and 150,000, which is 90,000, which the patient promised to pay in 15 days. From the perspective of the business, that amount is not yet cash on July 19. But still, it has to record an increase in another type of asset, the right to receive money, amounting to 90,000 pesos from the patient in the future. That right is known by the account title, Accounts Receivable. We debit accounts receivable because the right to collect money, which is an asset, increased. As you already know, the normal balance or increased side of asset is debit. Notice now, the total amount of our debit is 240,000, which is equal to the total amount of credit. And not to forget the explanation. Next transaction, July 31. Paid for the following: electricity bill, 12,000 pesos, rent, 50,000 pesos, and salary, 20,000 pesos. Obviously, all these are expenses. The clinic received electricity service. It was allowed to occupy a certain space for the conduct of its business. It received employment service. Receiving service means incurring expense. For the electricity service, the most appropriate account given in the list of account names is utilities expense. For rent, rent expense. And for salary, salaries expense. Not salary expense, but salaries expense. Remember, we need to use the specific account names given in the problem. Debit. Because the normal balance of expense is debit. From the word paid, the cash of the clinic decreased. Hence, credit cash for the total amount of this fee. 82,000. Then, explanation. Next, July 31. Medical supplies on hand, 15,000 pesos. Did the business purchase medical supplies on this date, July 31? No. This is not a purchase transaction. How about an investment transaction? Does this sentence indicate that the owner invested medical supplies on July 31? No. The statement simply reads, medical supplies on hand, 15,000 pesos. Medical supplies on hand, meaning the medical supplies in the possession of the clinic. In short, the asset. Medical supplies on July 31 amounts to 15,000 pesos. Recall that July is the first month of operations of the clinic. So there were no medical supplies yet at the beginning of July, which were carried over from the month of June. But on July 3, the clinic bought medical supplies worth 50,000 pesos for cash. Remember? That's why we debited the asset medical supplies here on July 3. After this transaction on July 3, there was no other mentioned transaction which affected the account title medical supplies. Now, by the end of July, out of the 50,000 pesos worth of medical supplies purchased on July 3, the clinic only has 15,000 pesos left. On July 3, it bought medical supplies amounting to 50,000 pesos. By the end of the month, only 15,000 pesos worth of the asset medical supplies remained. What happened to the difference of 35,000 pesos? Used up by the clinic. When we say medical supplies worth 35,000 pesos were used up, are those supplies still asset? No more. Those are already expense. If those 35,000 pesos worth of medical supplies used up are not assets anymore, then we need to decrease the asset account medical supplies by crediting it for that amount. If those are already expense, since those have been used up already, then we must increase the expense account medical supplies expense by debiting it also for 35,000 pesos. And finally, explanation. Record medical supplies. Thank you for watching.